The scroll bar allows users to select a numeric value from 0 to 1 by dragging the handle of the scroll bar. Scroll bars are usually used to set or change a value on another UI element or component. Scroll bars are commonly used with a scroll rect, which can hold and mask contents too large to be easily viewed. The scroll rect will use the value from the scroll bar to control how its contents are scrolled. For more information on scroll rects, please see the information linked below. The scroll bar's value is set by the position of the handle along the length of the scroll bar. The value is a normalized value that starts at 0 at one end of the scroll bar and increases up to 1 at the other end. A value of 0.5 indicates the halfway point. To create a new scroll bar, use the Create menu to Create UI Scroll Bar. Like all UI elements, the scroll bar element must be the child of a canvas. If one is not present when creating a pre-made scroll bar, a new canvas will be created. For more information on the canvas, please see the information linked below. When the scroll bar is created, it is made from a family of game objects. The children are the rect transform and image components that define the sliding area and the handle graphic. The parent game object is where the required scroll bar script resides. The background image is a component on the parent game object. Interactable determines whether or not this particular scroll bar will accept input. To prevent interaction with a scroll bar, set interactable to false. When interactable is set to false, the transition state for the scroll bar element will be set to the disabled state. By default, the scroll bar element will display the normal state of the scroll bar. Depending upon the transition mode chosen, a scroll bar can also display a highlighted, pressed, and disabled state. Transition mode determines whether or not the scroll bar element will display any of these additional states. And if so, controls the slider's look in each state and the style of the transitions between the states. The transition mode property is shared by many UI elements and will be covered in its own lesson. For more information on transitions and the transition mode property, please see the information linked below. When using transitions with a scroll bar, it is worth noting that, with the exception of the animation transition mode, any visual changes are only seen in the handle graphic, not the rest of the UI element. Navigation describes how the selection of UI elements is handled when using keyboard or controller input. Navigation is shared by many UI elements and will be covered in its own lesson. For most circumstances, navigation can simply be set to automatic. For more information on navigation, please see the information linked below. Handle rect is a reference to the rect transform on the graphic used for the handle. Direction sets both the axis and the direction of the value changed. The value is a normalized value that starts with 0 at one end of the scroll bar and increases up to 1 at the other end. For example, with the choice of left to right, the starting value of 0 will be at the left of the scroll bar, and the value of the scroll bar will increase proportionally as the handle moves from left to right, with the value of 1 at the right. The choices for direction are left to right to left, bottom to top, and top to bottom. The value is the current value of the scroll bar. When the value is set in the inspector during edit time, this will set the starting value for the scroll bar. Size is the fractional size of the handle within the scroll bar, in a range of 0 to 1. Number of steps is the number of distinct scroll positions allowed by the scroll bar. For a smooth, continuous scroll, set this value to 0 or 1. The UI framework contains a powerful event system. This is created when the canvas is created. When the event system detects a click or a drag on the scroll bar, the event system will call an onValueChanged event. The scroll bar component includes a built-in onValueChanged function list that contains a list of all the functions that are called when the scroll bar values change. Additional events can be detected and used by the scrollbar element, but this requires an additional component to be attached. For more information on how to use the built-in functions list, events, the event system, and event triggers, please see the information link below. In most cases, the scrollbar will be used with a scroll rect, which will automatically use the dynamic value of the scrollbar when they are associated. For more information on the scroll rect, please see the information linked below.